So this is day 2 of the 5K in 10 day challenge. Now, unfortunately, we didn't do day 1 and 2 back to back consecutively. That's just not how it went. However, still 10 days nonetheless. Okay, did it take 10 days of actual work to make this money? Now, quick update. Day 1, y'all, I made 200 little funky ass dollars. Remember I said already this Thursday I'm at work, this day 1. Yeah, I made $200 that night. It was Thursday, it was weird, it was, you know, whatever. Let me stop at this yellow light. I'm actually on our way to work now. But anyway, yeah, so only made the $200 the first day. So today is day 2. We're going to see what we can come up with. That bus just made a really weird turn. I wish I had the camera facing that way. But anyway, so yeah, it's day 2. We're going to see what we come up with. And the thing is this, guys, you know, you got to be in it to win it. Let me turn her down. Got to be in it to win it. Never know. You never know what someone has in their pocket. You never know what kind of night you're gonna have, right? And you never know who's gonna show up, right? Gotta be in it to win it. So tonight I'm in it to win it, and I did, y'all. I felt, because I was actually gonna come to work last night, which was a Sunday night, didn't, for a number of different reasons. I've been up since maybe 5 that morning prior to. By the time it came down to it, it was cold out. Oh, it was cold and raining. I have a multitude of reasons and excuses why I did not go to work. So, nevertheless, you know when you're not feeling it. It was just one of those nights when I just wasn't feeling it. So, that's why I didn't go. But anyway, nonetheless, we're on our way to work now. I'm going to chime in the dressing room, right? And let's find out what kind of night this is going to be, because one thing about it, you know, regardless of what, I don't care if I only go in here and make $100, y'all. The point is, we ended to win it. We're gonna see. Yeah, the goal is 5,000 for our 10 days of work. We may very well exceed that goal, right? So, you know, if for whatever reason, if I maybe fall short tonight, and you know, maybe I don't hit the quota, that's all right. Because, oh, what the hell. I was just going on about my day. Okay. As I was saying, so if I maybe don't meet the goal, it's okay, because we will live to hustle. I'm just making sure you see me, sir. We'll live to hustle another day. So, we pulling up on the block. Pulling up. Gotta go in this raggedy-ass garage, but we're gonna pull up and let's see. Let's see what type of night we're about to have. So stay tuned. Put that heat on it. Straightened out my little ones. Can you see it? Wait a minute. Let me pick them up. Alright, so I already straightened out the ones. I already straightened them out. Need to go ahead and count them. Oh, and I also had some 5s in the pile. So, Anyway, I'm about to go ahead and get dressed, count out these ones, so I can go ahead and get out of here, because it's not even 2 yet. It's about 1:45. So if I'm lucky, I'll make it out of here before everybody else. So I'll shine back in. Give me 1 second. Yeah. Okay. So I'm in the club. I'm at y'all can't see the sign, but at Rosario's. I'll take you through the drive-through with me. I had to put this bonnet on, y'all, because this hair is all the way down my back. 28, but on me, you know, I'm only 5 feet, so it is looking like about 30 inches. And I was like, God damn, I'm damn near sitting on my hair. Let me just put this bonnet back on. Anyway, all right. So tonight, I made like $270, something like that. Basically enough to put up $200 towards the the 5K and 10-day challenge. $40 to tip in tomorrow night. Right now, getting buy my little crab cake, buy some blunts. That was basically. Literally the breakdown of that 270. Okay, but we're gonna put up 2 towards the challenge. So right now we about 400. We 400 in on the 5K and 10-day challenge. So it's day 2, 400 in. So we are $4,600 short of the goal. But we going back to work tomorrow. And you know what? I really was not planning on working. I wasn't planning on working Halloween. I'm up in the air about it. May or may not. I don't know. Because Halloween is my favorite holiday, and I would much rather be out, for All Hallows Eve, celebrating. Right, as opposed to, I don't know. We'll see. We'll see where we are within the 5K 10-day challenge. We're gonna hit tomorrow's day 3, so we'll do day 3 and all that stuff. This vlog will be day 1 and 2. By the time I show you day 2 and 3, day 3, 4, and 5 will be in the next vlog. But I want to touch on something real quick. I probably should have screenshotted her question, but I told her, one of you guys, one of these subs had a question for me, and it basically, I'm just going to summarize the question right now. Her question was, I'm not going to summarize. This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to, because I don't want to do that to her. She reached out for my advice, and I'm going to do her justice, and actually, I'm going to read your question, baby. Let me get in the house, because what I'm going to have to do, I'm going to have to screenshot it, because I'm doing everything off the same phone. So let me screenshot it, read it, and I will pull it back up so I can read it. And that's how we'll end this vlog. I'm going to go ahead and answer that question. So let me get this crab cake, and I'll be right back. Hello, hello, hello. Good morning. Okay. So I said that I was going to answer my subscriber's question, and I'm going to do that now. All right. Well, bear with me if you see me looking down. It's because I actually took the time to make a few points, okay? But Miss Shabrina? Yeah, Miss Shabrina, I'm going to go ahead and read your question, okay? If that's all right. Because she asks in the question, she says, "It's me again, LOL. Could you one day do a vlog on financial insecurity
in a relationship or offer advice. I'm in my early 30s and my date is in his late 50s. I truly like him, parentheses, we have the same birthday, how could I not? LOL. But he owns 3 businesses and I'm in the sex industry also and he doesn't know. I'm constantly worrying about money. He has offered to help take care of everything, but I'm so used to being single and doing everything on my own, I don't want him to see me as a burden. It's so easy to get money from other men, but when it comes to him, I don't want him to have to be burdened with my problems. But I also want him to know that it's not easy over here as far as me sleeping with him. Girl, I don't know what the hell to do. So, Miss Shabrina, first of all, thank you for your question. A few points that I want to make. You spoke about, you said, could I speak on financial insecurity within a relationship? So, the first thing that I want to speak on as far as that is, number one, I think that can heavily tie into your self-esteem and what it is that you feel that you either bring or don't bring to the table. For us as women, in terms of finances, right? As far as a man is concerned, we could never be able to impress a man, right, by our finances or being able to outdo him with our finances. The only men that we can really impress with finances are men who ultimately have the intentions of wanting to go 50-50 with you or just in some kind of a way wanting to benefit off of your financial security in some type of way and isn't really interested in being able to help you the other way around as a man and as a provider, right? So for men naturally, in terms of natural roles, are protectors and providers. So, in your question, you mentioned that you didn't want to be a burden to him. You also mentioned that you didn't want him to see you as being easy as far as being able to sleep with. And you mentioned, you know, he has 3 businesses. Like you said, you don't want to come off as a burden, but he has offered to be able to help you. So what I want to say to you that is, if this man has offered to help you, because you also mentioned that you yourself worry about money constantly. So if this man has, first of all, he's around you, he's in your presence. So obviously he likes you and he likes what it is that you have to offer outside of your financial situation, and he in fact has offered to help you. What is it in you that makes you feel like you would be some type of a burden? Again, for men are providers and protectors, so you would be doing him a disservice to not allow him to come to your aid, come to your rescue, be the damsel in distress. Men have a need to be able to provide and protect for the women that are in their life that they actually do care about. So if this man actually does care about you, again, you would be doing him a disservice by not allowing him to fetch and carry for you, as they used to say, right? So you mentioned, you know, that you are also a sex worker. So baby, like you said, it's easy for you to be able to ask for things from other men, but when it comes to him, for whatever reason, you have this apprehension. I think as women, especially in our line of work, yeah, it could be, I guess maybe what you might be feeling is a little intimidation because you do like him, and in these other instances, you're dealing with men that are essentially your clients, so you really don't care about how they personally feel about your demands either way. You have indifference to that. So what I would say is you're going to have to find that balance to be able to find that same indifference within your relationship, because otherwise what you're doing is you're basically sending the message that, you know, you don't want to be provided for. You don't expect him to, you know, care for you in that way and to provide for you and protect you in that way, to make sure that you're good. You're sending the message that, oh, I can just do it on my own instead of third. And you know what I mean? Like, oh, no, I don't need anything. I mean, it, you know, it sounds, in theory, like you would think that it sounds cute to set it there. But again, if you deep down, that's not how you feel, you're doing yourself a disservice, you're doing him a disservice. Like I said, as sex workers, within the industry, yes, it's very, very easy to, when you like someone, you want to give them a pass, and, you know, you're worried about how they're viewing you, this, that, and third. Again, find a balance. Keep in mind that it's you that they are pursuing and not the other way around. And if they, in fact, want to be in your presence and be privy to the privilege of having your feminine energy around, then yes, they should, by all means, have no problem with providing for you, and you shouldn't have a problem with accepting that. As women, we are receivers. So I think you might be dealing with some imbalances as far as your feminine energy is concerned. Work on being okay with receiving. Work on being okay with asking for help, okay? I actually did a video on being the damsel in distress. So if you go on my playlist, go down, 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 and look at my video on being the damsel in distress. So don't let, you know, the fact that, hey, these other guys that you don't really care about their opinion impede on, now you have a guy who actually does, excuse me, you actually care about his opinion. Don't let that stop you from actually voicing what it is that you do need out of the fear that it would somehow drive him away. This has everything to do with hypergamy, right? In hypergamous culture, women subscribe to a traditional role, which is to allow the man to be the protector and provider, and in turn provide that nurturing feminine energy companionship that man would need to be able to be successful in what it is that he is trying to do. Okay, so study hypergamous culture. Also, I already mentioned being a damsel in distress, and this last point just kind of ties back into our industry in terms of, and when we say sex worker, maybe you could be, whether you're an escort, whether you're a dancer, you could be a cam girl, you could be doing OnlyFans, you could, all of these things are in the realm of sex worker. Okay, so we are used to being compensated for our time, for our energy. So within a relationship, the dynamic of that, instead of it being an actual exchange, hey, you know, my time for X amount of dollars, you now have to, again, the exchange becomes allowing the man to, if and when you are in need, allowing him to step in. Oh, yeah, man, oh my God, my car, I really want to see you, but my car, my tires, they are just so worn down. Oh, well, baby, what's the tires? Well, how much are they? Wink, wink. You know what I mean? Oh, baby, oh my goodness, I really want to go out. I really, you know, I want to look good for you. I feel like I don't have anything to wear. I saw this really nice, oh my God, I saw this really nice negligee at Victoria's Secret, and I wish I could wear it for you. At Victoria's Secret, well, how much was it? Wink, wink. You know what I mean? Damsel in distress. Allow them to step in. Allow him to step in and compensate you. This is the way that, instead of it being, like I said, X amount of time for X amount of dollars, now he is compensating you by being there and you know, being able to meet your needs, your financial needs. Okay, so I'm going to wrap up on that note. I hope this answered your question. And again, this is wrapping up day two of the 5K and 10-day challenge. I actually last night had night three, and it was a bust. It was a complete bust. I made no money. I'll speak on that later on in the up and coming vlog. But for right now, I'm gonna sign off, and I'll be back very, very soon with the next vlog. So this is Mama Monster signing out. Stay tuned.